All right, let's continue our example with ABC and their skip loader. We already projected out all the expenses in here. These are in the yellow are the depreciation expenses. But one of the other things that we want to calculate here is accumulated depreciation. Accumulated depreciation is pretty simple. It's the total amount of depreciation that's been taken up to a certain point in time. Okay, after the first year, the cumulative straight line depreciation after 1 year is $18,000. After 2 years, it's $36,000. It's the first $18,000 plus this next $18,000. After 3 years, it would be the $36,000 from here plus the $18,000 we take in this year. It'd be $72,000 this next year, which would be the sum of this plus this plus this plus this. In the last fifth year, it would be the sum of this plus this plus this plus this plus this. Okay? The cumulative depreciation expenses or accumulated depreciation for the skip loader using a faster depreciation method would simply that amount, and then you take that amount plus this year's and just do that all the way across. Notice that when you're looking at that, it's this year's depreciation plus all the depreciation you've taken in the prior years. I mean, it's the accumulated number for this, it would simply be the sum of all the depreciation you've taken in the prior years, okay? This one would be the sum that you've taken through the first 4 years, all right? Accumulated depreciation. All right, so why do we need to know that? We use the accumulated depreciation to get the book value. If I add those numbers down here, the cost of the skip loader, now these are balance sheet numbers. What do we report on the balance sheet? The balance sheet lists the assets we own. Okay, using the straight line depreciation, we paid $150,000 for the skip loader. But after the first year, it's not worth $150,000 anymore, is it? Because I've used up some of it driving the skip loader around. If you take the accumulated depreciation and subtract it from the cost, that gives you the book value at the end of the year. What we want to report is the part that we haven't used up yet. Okay, so it costs $150,000. We've accumulated $18,000 depreciation. Book value is $132,000. At the end of the second year, you paid $150,000. That was the cost. Your accumulated depreciation is the 36, 2 years of depreciation from when you bought the skip loader. And then the book value at the end of the year keeps going down. Okay. At the end of the fifth year, the book value will be $60,000, which coincidentally is what we intend to sell it for. Using the double declining balance, though, notice that the book value of the skip loader will be lower. That means our asset value will be lower. Still the same cost. The cumulative depreciation the first year is $60,000. And so our book value, the reported value, is $90,000. After the first year, only $60,000. The second year, $30,000, or fourth year, or fifth year. Notice we end up in the exact same place. At the end of 5 years, I paid $150,000 for a skip loader. I've used up $90,000 total of its value. It's carried on my books, on my assets, at $60,000. Same for both methods. It's just you get there faster using the double declining balance method. That doesn't mean the skip loader is worth less. The skip loader is worth whatever it's worth. The accounting statements tell you what you paid for something, not what you can sell it for. By the way, you get there 5 years down the road and somebody might say, oh, skip loaders, man, they're really hot these days. $60,000, I'll give you $100,000 for it. Okay, and then you would report a gain because you sold something that your claimant's worth $60,000 for $100,000. You'd pay income taxes on the gain. But that's down the road. Let's just make sure that we can make a distinction between depreciation expenses, and that's the annual expense claimed on the income statement. Accumulated depreciation is the sum of all the depreciation we have taken on a specific asset. Book value is simply the cost minus accumulated depreciation. And that's what it's reported on the balance sheet.